We're on this job today. Guy wants to put in a shed, 24 by 24 gravel pad is what I'm building him. So all of these trees need to move. Big log needs to move. So we're kind of going to be going from, I had it marked, but the rain washed it off. I'm going to be going from like here down to that spruce tree there and then in this way. So not a lot of big trees. These are all pretty small. So that's pretty cool. And this spruce tree might need to come out. Check this out though. I hope you can see through the camera. There's hundreds of little fish down there. And there are some big ones there. They say this thing's waterproof, right? Pretty cool, you can dunk a camera underwater nowadays. You can even do that with my phone. It's got like an IP68, I think, even water rating on it. IP67 at least. Okay, let's get to it. Birch tree. I've never seen a birch that big around here. I don't know when it would have been taken down, but like these are cottonwoods. Cottonwood isn't this. This is very different. So I don't know how old that would have been, but pretty interesting to see how the landscape changes over the years from big giant birch trees to we've got a mix of Engelmann spruce and blue spruce and whole bunch of viney stuff, and yeah, neat. Okay, I think I'm pretty happy with this. The dump is closed today, so I can't haul the brush away. But I'll be doing that tomorrow, and then I can work on making this level. Okay, I think I'm gonna call this a day. I just tucked the excavator in there for the night. Next step is gonna be hauling those sticks and brush and what away with the dump truck. So. I think it might rain. Okay, we're back the next day. It stopped raining. It looks like it did rain here pretty good all day yesterday. Everything's wet, so glad I called it. Always a good idea to look at your cap and make sure no one put anything in your tank, but it's pretty safe out here, I think. We'll be right back. like we got one more to do. I'm spinning out. So hopefully I can back down a little farther onto this gravel. Oh man. That was close. Oh dear. Damn, they're gonna back down in here again, but I'm not gonna go the whole way. That was spooky. Okay, that's probably good enough for now. This is why you idle them up. See the oil pressure jump up 10 pounds there? A little extra oil pressure is always good. So, I shouldn't spin out there. I shouldn't have spun out down there, but I've got a lot of room to back up and get a runway, and I can always pivot in this way if I have to. But let's get the brush up here. Thank you. He wants me to haul these trees away too, so I'm just gonna buck the long limbs off it so I can haul it with my gooseneck trailer. I didn't bring my big saw, but I just thought, if I go home and grab my Dodge in the big trailer, I gotta go all the way home. If this saw will cut these in half, I can fit them in Louise. So let's try it. That's out of fuel. Maybe we're all fueled up. Okay, let's go drop this load off. Come back and bring these logs home. Call it a day. But I've been wrong before. I guess I better hurry up. You see the storm clouds in the distance there? Those have doubled in size since I was heading to the dump. Ravens or crows or whatever, they've been hanging out. Yeah. Okay, I put it in gear. Let's see if it rolled. Nope. I always wondered about that. If when you're putting heavy stuff in it, if the brakes actually hold good enough that they won't rotate. They do. They're supposed to anyways. Mine seem to. I've never slept while I'm getting loaded. Held on. Mine sticks. It sticks pretty good. That's usually what I do when I'm loading by myself. The reason I do these on the passenger side is if they come loose on the road and I have to pull over, I'm on the non-traffic side. And we're off to the rodeo. There's a pull out, but yeah, this one comes loose right away. Okay. That should hold for few more bumps. The road's just so rough, everything rattles loose. Yeah, look at that. This one I had tight. Oh, it's still tight. Okay. It's bouncy. Under 400, good enough. If you're wondering how the old truck handles a load like this, so that excavator, only about 16,000 pounds. This truck handles it awesome. I've got a BD exhaust brake on it, and 5-speed with a dual disc clutch. It's got 410 gears. I'm pretty sure it might even be 456 gears, because it's slow. At 100, you are doing, 2300 RPM or so at 100 kilometers an hour, so 62 mile an hour. It's slow, but it's perfectly fine because that helps you slow down going down hills. This will go down a quite a steep hill, flick that exhaust brake on and it's perfect. It's perfectly fine. this customer wanted a gravel pad. That's what I gave him. 25 by 25. It's fairly level. He's not putting concrete down, so. And there it is. Let's go work on something else.